So today's class is the continuation of the topic ratio and proportion. Now problem number 10. The problem says that there three numbers are in the ratio half is to one third is to one fourth. If the sum of their squares is 224, find the numbers. If the sum of their squares is 224, find the numbers. The given ratio can be transferred into the simple form is like that. So half is to one third is to one fourth. Now 2, 3, 4, LCM of 2, 3, 4 is what? 12. So we should multiply each one by 12. So half into 12 is to one third is to 12 is to one fourth is to 12. That means 6 is to 4 is to 3. So now since the given ratio is 6 is to 4 is to 3, so we can consider the numbers like that: 6x, 4x, and 3x. Sure. So according to the question, look at that. If the sum of their squares is 244, that means 6x square plus 4x square plus 3x square, that is equal to 224. So after simplification, we got x square equal to 4x. So x should be plus minus 2. We cannot take the negative sign. So we can take only x equal to 2. So 6x should be 6 into 2, that is 12. And 4x should be 4 into 2, that is 8. And 3x should be 3 into 2, that is equal to 6. Hence the required numbers are 12, 8, 6. So our next topic is proportion. An equality of two ratios is called a proportion. So the remark: four non-zero quantities A, B, C, D are said to be in proportion if and only if A is to B equal to C is to D. That means if this condition A is to B equal to C is to D holds, then we can say that A, B, C, D are in proportion. Got it? And A is to B means A by B, and C is to D means C by D. Now for example, 2, 3, 4, 6 are in proportion since 2 by 3 equal to 4 by 6. Sure? In the definition of proportion, A, B, C, D are called terms. Here A is the first term, B is the second term, C is the third term, and D is the fourth term. Now problem number 11. If 6 is to x is equal to 2 is to 13, find x. It's a very simple sum. Look at that. X is to, 6 is to x equal to 2 is to 13 means x by 6 by x equal to 2 by 13. So x should be 6 into 13 by 2, so x should be 39. It's a very simple sum. Now, problem number 12. Find the fourth proportion to 5, 4, 25. Okay? So for this problem, let the fourth proportion be x. Then, look at that. This is the first term, second term, third term, and fourth term be x, obviously. Fourth proportion be x means fourth term is x. So since 5, 4, 25 and x are in proportion, so we can write 5 is to 4 equal to 25 is to x. So x should be, after simplification, x should be 20. Is it clear? Absolutely. Now continued proportion. The definition of continued proportion is the non-zero quantities of the same kind A, B, C, D, E, F, dot, dot, dot are said to be in continued proportion if and only if A by B equal to B by C equal to C by D equal to D by E equal to E by F equal to dot dot dot. Got it? Now in particular, three non-zero quantities of the same kind A, B, C are said to be in continued proportion. That means A, B, C are said to be in continued proportion if the ratios of A to B, that means A is to B, is equal to the ratio of B to C, that is B is to C. That is if and only A by B equal to B by C. Got it? If A by B equal to B by C, this condition happen, then A, B, C are said to be continued proportion. Is it clear? For example, 2, 4, 8 are in continued proportion since 2 by 4 equal to 4 by 8. Obviously, 2 by 4 is how much? Half. 4 by 8 is how much? Half. So half equal to half. So we can write 2 by 4 equal to 4 by 8. And since this condition happened, then we can say that 2, 4, 8 are in continued proportion. Now problem number 14. If x, 3, 12, y are in continued proportion, find x and y. Sure? Four numbers are in continued proportion. This is given. So now, given that x, 3, 12, y are in continued proportion, then x by 3 equal to 3 by 12 equal to 12 by y. Got it? So now this condition happens since these four numbers are in continued proportion. Now from the first two, we get x by 3 equal to 3 by 12, and after simplification we got x equal to 3 by 4. And from the second part, 3 by 12 equal to 12 by y, and solving this we get y equal to 48. Got it? Now the next problem, number 15. If p, q, r are in the continued proportion, then prove that p is to r equal to p square is to q square. Got it? Given that p, q are in continued proportions. So now given p, q and r in continued proportion, then from the definition we can say that p by q equal to q by r. And up cross multiplied we get q square equal to pr. Call it equation number 1. Now we can show that p is to r equal to p square is to q square. So now we starting with p square is to q square, and that means p square by q square. So now p square by q square is value is what? Pr, put it. So p square by pr, pp, 1 pp cancel out. So p by r, and p by r means p is to r. So p square is to q square equal to p is to r. Proved. Next sum, number 14. Now sum number 16. If a plus c equal to 2b and 1 by b plus 1 by d equal to 2 by c, then prove that a, b, c, d are in proportion. So now it is given that 1 by b plus 1 by d equal to 2 by c. After simplification we got b, d plus b by bd equal to 2c, cross multiplied c into this one, that means cd plus bc, and bd into 2, that means 2bd. And now what is the value of 2b? 2b value is a plus c, put it. So a plus c into d. So now multiplying we get cd plus bc equal to ad plus cd. And this cd both side cancel out. So bc equal to ad, and this can be written as a by b equal to c by d. And since a by b equal to c by d, this means that a, b, c, d are in continued proportion. Thank you.